In this video, we discuss the solution to the last problem of Quiz 3, Fall 2016 in ECSE 1010. So this is a circuit which actually combines more than one of the types of circuits that we've seen previously. In fact, if you look at this even briefly, you should notice that there's an amplifier here and an amplifier right here. Okay, and we are going to analyze both of these amplifiers because they're commonly used as when we connect some kind of a light sensor in order to make a reasonable level voltage. And we have two options of standard amplifiers, and we consider them both here. In both of these problems, we need to go, we'll notice that both of these parts of the configuration, you notice that we've got a capacitor in series with a resistor, a capacitor in series with a resistor. And we considered that previously in problem 4, where we had a resistor in series with a capacitor. And we've discovered that at the frequency that we are interested in, the impedance of this was very small compared to the impedance of these, so we can neglect it. And what we do when we neglect it is we replace it with a short circuit. In other words, what we're saying is that this is such a small impedance compared to this one that we get a reasonable answer by just saying, well, it's not small. Let's just make it as small as we can make it. Let's make it zero. This is, in fact, what a capacitor becomes at high frequencies is, in effect, a short circuit. So what we want to do here is do the same kind of analysis we did back in problem number 4. And take a look at the capacitive impedance, which is indicated right here. So I plugged the numbers in because we've got the value of the capacitance, and we've also got the frequency, which it's right here, 1 kilohertz, which is in the middle of a specified audio range. So I plug all those in, I get 4.83, not 4.83K, but 4.83, which is very small compared to 1K. So we're gonna just treat this as zero. And then we replace both of the capacitors as short circuits, okay? And that makes analysis very simple because then this just becomes a standard configuration and this becomes a standard configuration. And what those standard configurations are, we've also seen in previous problems. That's why the problems are configured the way they are on this quiz. So here is an inverting amplifier, all right? And so we have an input resistor coming into the negative input. We have a feedback resistor going from the negative input to the output, and we've grounded the input. And that's in fact what this is. Once we've shorted this out, we have this as the input resistor and that as the feedback resistor. And so the gain is going to be equal to, for such a configuration, is going to be 10K divided by 1K with a minus sign in front. All right, so the gain of that one, so the one on the left is an inverting amplifier and its gain is going to be minus 10. And again, in the back in problem 3, we also saw this configuration, which is there's the feedback resistor comes back to the negative input, and then there's a resistor to ground, and then the input comes into the positive input of the amplifier. And since this is a short circuit, the input is coming into the positive input. Here is the feedback resistor coming into the negative input and the resistor to ground. So that is the same exact circuit as this one. With one difference, okay, there is this resistor right here, which is connected. So between the source and the input, there is that resistor. But remember, one of the other things about op-amps is that we have what are called the golden rules of op-amps, and so there is no current going through this resistor. So this voltage is the same as this voltage over here. No current through the resistor means there's no voltage across it from Ohm's law. So this voltage is the same as this voltage. And sure enough, we can actually even neglect this resistor completely. It doesn't have to do with anything. So we have the input voltage showing up at the positive input, which is right there. We have these two resistors, which are these two resistors up here. And again, the formula for, in that case, the gain is equal to this resistor divided by this resistor plus 1. So 9 divided by 1 plus 1, that gain is also 10, but now it has a positive sign. Okay, before we go to the next part of the problem, just notice that the input here is a sine wave. And if you remember from the way this is done in LTSpice, it has an offset of 4.4, which is actually pointed out right here, and an amplitude of 0.03, which is right here, or 30 millivolts, and a frequency of 1,000, which was also pointed out right here. So all this information, you didn't have to necessarily remember how this notation works, because it's all included in the write-up here. So we have something. We have a sinusoidal input with an amplitude of 0.03 and an offset of 4.4. Okay, and what we have on the next page is this is a plot of the input voltage with the offset. And the input voltage, remember, is 4.4 volts, and the sinusoidal part is 0.03. So the wiggle is very small compared to the offset. So in order to show that better, it's plotted down here with the offset removed. So it's just basically indicated here that the offset has been removed. So then the question here in part D is, what is the mathematical expression, assuming there's no phase, because we don't care about that, that's just the source. What's the mathematical expression for the voltage of the source? And it's 0.03, which is the amplitude, the sine of omega, which is right here, times t. And omega is just 2 pi times 1,000 or 2,000 pi. And so that's, you can write it as 2,000 pi or as 6.28k. So then from the knowledge of the gain of each amplifier and your expression for the input voltage, write the expression for the voltage at the two outputs, okay? And compare the results you get from each amplifier. And so the output voltage for each amplifier, they're going to be equal in magnitude, but they're going to be opposite signs, and I haven't actually indicated that here. So it's going to be 0.3 because it's 10 times bigger. Remember, it was 0.03, 0.3. There should actually be a sine expression right here that got left out. And this stays the same. In the problem from the other, I'm going to come back to part F in just a second, but in the problem from the other section, this is the same, this was the same. You notice that everything's the same except the capacitances are different. But again, you get 10.6 in this case versus 2K. And again, you can neglect the capacitance and you can just make this into a short circuit. Left is inverting, right is non-inverting. You get the same thing here, which is minus 10 and plus 10. And I lost something here. Okay, and these look the same. Again, I haven't indicated that there's a sine difference here, but it ends up being 0.3 times the sine of omega t. All right, so that's very general in both of those cases. Now we come back to part F. So in the last part of this question, we want to look at what happens when the light level changes and 1K, this 1K right here, becomes 2K. And we'll see a significant difference between the two types of amplifiers when we do this. Remember that in this case that the gain is given by this divided by this. So if this goes up to 2K, the gain now becomes minus 5. If this goes to 2K, it doesn't change anything. The gain remains the same because these resistors are fixed. This is the one that's varying. And remember, this resistor doesn't do anything because there's no voltage drop across that resistor because there's no current being carried by it. So when I calculate these things, here is the gain on the left and the right gain remains 10. And so this shows you one of the advantages of using the non-inverting amplifier, because you will always get the same gain value even when the resistance changes. And so in this case, the gain changed, and here nothing actually changed. So on the left, the gain goes down as the input signal goes up, basically. In the other case, there's one more here. In this case, we've got in the original case, it was 2K and it went down to 1K, so it goes backwards. And sure enough, the gain actually goes up in this case, so we end up with a gain of minus 20. The gain stays 10 for the non-inverting case. And so that was the thing that you were supposed to notice from this configuration, that the I've lost it here now. Here's the version of it, that this amplifier over here, which actually has many pluses, and this amplifier over here has many pluses, but one of the big advantages of the non-inverting amplifier is that what happens at the source here in terms of its resistance does not affect the gain of the overall circuit, whereas in this case the gain is affected. And that's it for this problem. The purpose here was to look at two different circuits that are doing basically the same job and see what happens when the source conditions change, because we're working with a voltage divider where one of the resistors is a variable resistor. That is, in the case of the I can actually show it down here again. We have a voltage divider. It's not being drawn very well, and this is the photocell, and this varies. This is fixed. Okay, and so if we're taking the output here and the input here, if this is driving the inverting amplifier, the gain actually changes with the voltage conditions over here, the lighting conditions. And with the non-inverting amplifier, the gain does not change. And so actually in the case of the non-inverting amplifier, the output is more predictable and easier to quickly understand, because the only thing that matters is the voltage change here, not the combination of the voltage change and the resistance change. And that's it for the solution to quiz 3 from the fall of 2016 in ECSE 1010.